Next topic here is quadrature carrier multiplexing, also known as, it is also known by the name quadrature amplitude modulation or QAM. All of you would have seen this QAM. Even today our mobile signals, many of them are quadrature amplitude modulated signals only. Whether I use the name quadrature carrier multiplexing or quadrature amplitude modulation, quadrature amplitude modulation, both are one and the same. Okay, please remember. So what is this QAM? It is a technique in which more number of signals, or let me say more than one signal, can be transmitted using the same channel bandwidth. What is the bandwidth required by a DSB-SC signal? Somebody tell me, what's the bandwidth required by a DSB-SC signal? See, DSB-SC means like this. It varies from FC minus W to FC plus W, no carrier. What's the bandwidth? Why are you taking so long? This bandwidth is
2 omega.
2 omega.
2W, okay? This is not omega, it's W. 2W, or if I have a single tone, if you have a DSB-SC signal like this, single tone, this would be FC plus FM and this component would be FC minus FM. So the bandwidth would be 2 times FM or 2 times W, where W is the highest frequency component. Okay. We use omega in a different respect. So this is not omega, it's just W. We could have used some other term also. Okay. So the bandwidth of DSB-SC is 2W. In this, I can send only one message. In whatever we have studied till now, a single message can be sent within a bandwidth which is almost double that of the actual message signal. Remember, actual message signal occupies the bandwidth from 0 to W. Ideally, this is the bandwidth of the original message, M of F. Okay. But when we modulate, the bandwidth is getting doubled. It's becoming 2W. And in that 2W bandwidth, I'll be able to send one single message signal or just one single message. What if I want to send more than one message? I have to do some form of multiplexing, and that technique is called quadrature carrier multiplexing or quadrature amplitude modulation, where we will send two signals in the same bandwidth without interfering with each other. Can somebody guess what would that technique be? I've already put the block diagram also. The name itself tells you. You send two different messages on the same bandwidth by modulating them with two carriers which are in phase quadrature with each other. That's all. It's very simple. You see here in this diagram, I have the first message M1 given to the upper product modulator, to which the carrier is a cosine, AC cos 2 pi FCT, okay, in phase carrier. So now I'll get the DSB-SC output signal at this point, right? Similarly, I'll have a lower product modulator to which I'll give the second message signal, and the carrier which I give will be the sine carrier, 90 degree phase shifted carrier. Okay. So I'll get AC sine 2 pi FCT, that I'll multiply with M2 of T. So I have a sinusoidal signal here and a cosine carrier here. We can use an adder circuit, add up both the signals and transmit, and they will occupy the same bandwidth. Two messages are going in the same bandwidth, but without interfering with each other, because the two carriers are 90 degree out of phase with each other, or they are in phase quadrature with each other. Okay, so that's why this technique is called quadrature carrier modulation multiplexing, or here the amplitude will also vary, so it's called quadrature amplitude modulation. Okay, so let's try to see what's the output of the upper product modulator. What will I get here? Say I'll get the signal, the first DSP SC signal, AC cos 2 pi FCT into M1 of T. That's all. M1 of T into AC cos 2 pi FCT is the output of the upper product modulator. The output of the lower product modulator S2 of T will be AC sin 2 pi FCT into M2 of T, the second message. This message is M2, this is M1. Now, what should I do here? The final S of T is S1 of T plus S2 of T. We are sending both these signals, AC cos 2 pi FCT M1 of T plus AC sin 2 pi FCT into M2 of T. Okay? So, this is the final signal which goes out on the transmission channel. So, it is a multiplexed signal in the sense there are two messages, but both occupy the same bandwidth, which is the bandwidth of one DSB SC signal or 2W. Within a bandwidth of 2W, we are now able to send two messages, which is a what? It is very good. This technique we will modify later on, where we can send 16 messages or 64 messages. Today we are using 64 QAM easily, where we are going to send 64 different messages on the same bandwidth. We are going to enhance this later. Anyway, this is commonly used today, but first you understand the basics of quadrature amplitude modulation. So I hope you all understood this diagram, right? It's a simple DSB SC generator. One is in channel, lower is quadrature channel. The upper one generates the DSB SC signal with cosine carrier. The lower one generates DSB SC signal with sine carrier. Both are added and sent on the transmission line. Okay? So now, once this is done, at the receiver, whether we will be able to demodulate correctly, we should observe. So we should use two coherent detectors at the receiver. So let's move on to the receiver side. Anyway, what is transmitted, we have already seen here, S1 plus S2. Okay? And the total signal occupies the bandwidth of 2W or FM1 plus FM2. If message 1 has highest frequency FM1 and message 2 has highest frequency FM2. I have considered both have the same frequency, highest frequency, but if they have different frequencies, it will take the highest of the two. Okay. Now let's move on to the receiver. How does this QAM receiver work? As I told you, QAM receiver has what? An in-phase channel, okay, I channel, and a Q channel. Like in our Costa's loop, we have an I channel and Q channel. Only thing, there is no, it's not a loop and there is no feedback here. The received multiplexed signal is fed in to both the I channel and Q channel. Remember, your S of T is S1 plus S2. Okay. Here it is S1 plus S2, which is AC cos 2 pi FCT M1 of T plus AC sin 2 pi FCT M2 of T. So this is the signal which is fed here. It's a composite signal. Okay. And tell me what is the output. I want you to find what is the output at this point V01 of t and output at this point V02 of t. Multiply and check out. See, this signal should be multiplied with AC dash cos 2 pi FCT in this channel. See, this is the received signal. It should be multiplied with AC dash cos 2 pi FCT in the upper channel, and it should be multiplied with AC dash sin 2 pi FCT in the lower channel. So do it. I think it will come out of the meeting in a few seconds. You can join back. So what do I get here? V01 of t will be AC into AC dash. Just because of this, we don't consider amplitudes here. See, I have to write AC into AC dash or AC into A1, something like that. Okay. Here it is cos square 2 pi FCT into M1 of t into cos square 2 pi FCT, this product, this one into this. The product of the second one, I'll put a bracket here. I'll not. Anybody completed? V01 of t. What? AC dash. Let me write the received signal here. AC M1 of t. Yes? See, this is the received signal. This we are multiplying with cos 2 pi FCT into AC dash. Mute yourselves. So I am going to get M1 of t into cos square 2 pi FCT plus AC dash, the second term, into M2 of t into sin 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FCT. How do you simplify this? Simplify these product terms. AC dash, let it come out. M1 of t into, what is cos square theta? 1 plus cos 2 theta. 1 plus cos 4 pi FCT. Plus AC dash, we have it outside. M2 of t into, what is sin A cos A? What is sin A into cos A?
Sin 2A by A. By 2.
2A by 2, right? So, this is also everything all by 2s. I'll shift here. This will become 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. Cos square theta is 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. Okay, this is 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. And sin A cos A is sin 2A by 2, or sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta by 2. So I have this. Now, what do I have as the next stage? It's a low pass filter. So if I send this signal through low pass filter, what remains? If you want, you multiply and keep M1T into 1 plus M1T into cos 4 pi FCT plus M2T into sin 4 pi FCT. Correct? This is going through a low pass filter. What remains? All the high frequency components will get eliminated. This term goes off. cos 4 pi fct, sin 4 pi fct are all high frequency. What remains is only this. So you will get ac into ac dash by 2 m1 of t. Correct? So you can see the output of the upper channel, in phase channel, is ac ac dash by 2 into m1 of t, as we have proved just now. Is this clear? So can you do it likewise for the lower channel? Do it for the lower channel. Here I should multiply it with what? Instead of this, I'll multiply it with AC dash sin 2 pi FCT. This received signal, the received composite signal, should be multiplied with AC dash sin 2 pi FCT. Can you multiply and tell me the terms? The first term will be AC into AC dash M1 of T into again cos 2 pi FCT into sin 2 pi FCT. Okay. And the second term will be AC AC dash M2 of T into sin square 2 pi FCT. Correct. So if you simplify this, AC AC dash outside M1 of T, this is in the form cos theta sin theta, which will be sin 2 theta by 2. Okay, sin 2 theta by 2 plus the second AC AC dash we have outside, M2 of T into what is sin square theta? Can you tell me, can you tell this in terms of cos 2 theta? What is cos 2 theta? It is 1 minus 2 sin square theta, right? You can write it as 2 cos square theta minus 1, 1 minus 2 sin square theta. All this is cos 2 theta only. Or this is also 2 cos theta sin theta. All these are different forms of writing cos 2 theta. I hope you remember this trigonometry, right? So if I want sin square theta equivalent in terms of cos 2 theta, what would it become? This would be 1 minus cos 2 theta. Here 2 theta will be cos 4 pi FCT by 2. Is that okay? Sin square theta is 1 minus of cos 2 theta by 2. So we get this equivalent. Now multiply AC AC dash by 2 M1 of T sin 4 pi FCT plus AC AC dash by 2 M2 of T plus AC AC dash by 2, it's minus cos 4 pi FCT. Okay, so out of this signal, this is V02 of T. V02 of T. Out of this signal, can you tell me what remains after the low pass filter? If this signal passes through a low pass filter, this component will get eliminated because it is at high frequency. It is at the frequency 2fc. 2 pi into 2 fc into t. Okay. So this is at a high frequency. This will get eliminated. This term is at the message frequency. AC AC dash by 2 M2 of t. This remains. It won't get eliminated. whereas this last term is also at 4 pi fct. Even this term gets eliminated. So you can see what remains after the low pass filter. Yes, is half AC AC dash into M2 of T. So what did we prove now? We are proving that by multiplexing two signals in the same bandwidth using quadrature carriers, we are going to make use of quadrature carriers, one sine and one cosine, and we are sending both of them on the same bandwidth, we are still able to demodulate correctly or recover the signals correctly using two coherent detectors as shown. Okay, is this clear? This is the concept of quadrature carrier multiplexing or quadrature amplitude modulation. If you have any doubts, you can ask. Yes, if you don't have any doubts, I'll proceed with attendance. Anyway, the same concept is explained here, you can go through. Okay.